do you think's covering up the mountain?
Listen, the only thing across that ocean is Murska Air Base. That's Yuktabanian territory.
But haven't we been allies with the Yuks since the war 15 years ago?
Nagase, you keep flying like that and you'll die real soon.
I won't die soon.
You're flying number two on my wing. Gotta keep an eye on you or who knows what you'll get yourself into.
Probably hate this more than anybody. He used to have a lady friend over at Yuktabanian.
Captain!
Warning! Warning! Wardog Squadron, return to base immediately!
What happened? Yuktabanian just declared war.
Welcome, welcome everyone to Ace Combat 5, The Unsung War. Actually, no. No, gonna do this right. Hate that. Alright. New game. We're just gonna go to normal, and we're gonna begin.
15 years ago, there was a war. Well, war has broken out here plenty of times before. They've tried to invade the Southlands through the Northern Valley time and time again. Luck was never on their side, though, and their victories didn't last long. they didn't realize that times had changed. Facing one defeat after another, losing territory and watching the nation dwindle, they built up their industrial strength to unprecedented heights and used it to wage one final battle against the world. That was 15 years ago. They fought ferociously, but were utterly defeated. The Belkans, they committed the unthinkable. They used nuclear weapons on their own soil. Seeing this tragedy unfold before their own eyes, the victorious countries vowed to throw down their weapons. The world was once again at peace. And thanks to them, it seemed it would last forever. On a distant island, far away from civilization, the protectors of the peace take to the skies.
Sorry about this.
The captain's apology to me seemed misplaced. One instructor had survived the fight but crashed on landing. The other one was killed in action high up in the clouds. It wasn't his fault that the unidentified aircraft fired on us without warning. Nor was it his fault that the low altitude area where he sent his trainees was directly in front of the enemy. 8 people died because the command room had misplaced some zeros. That pilot in the number 7 was amazing. Did you see her fight back?
I couldn't bear to watch. Nagase, you keep flying like that and you'll die real soon.
I won't die soon.
The only surviving trainee's voice was almost a whisper.
Are you sure? You look like you couldn't hurt a fly.
Her face was pale, but she still managed to smile a bit for the camera. The photo, along with my camera, was confiscated by base security.
So this is my photo,
and the Red War never happened.
Huh.
I came to cover this remote island because I heard that a very unique squadron leader was stationed there. I didn't realize he was this unique, though. This bad-mouthed, good-natured old firebrand could take the greenest of rookies and forge him into a fearsome fighter pilot. Of course, that possibility vanished with the day's encounter. The only crew he had left now were Second Lieutenant Nagase and a few pilots that happened to be on the ground that day.
I know you don't like this, but we're short on people. Starting tomorrow, all you nuggets are going to be sitting alert. If we launch, stay glued to me up there. Nagase?
Sir.
You're flying number 2 on my wing. Gotta keep an eye on you, or who knows what you'll get yourself into.
Enemies, people! But don't get too comfortable. It's a grave situation for all of us right now. Let's get this briefing started.
Another aircraft of unknown origin has entered Ocean Federation airspace. We have confirmed the target type as a strategic recon plane flying at very high altitude. Despite our repeated warnings, it continues to penetrate our ages and was fired upon by Ocean Coastal Defense Force SAMs. We believe one of our SAMs damaged the unknown plane, but did not destroy it. Radar shows that the aircraft is currently losing altitude and is attempting to egress feet west towards the ocean. Intercept this target and force it to land for identification. Do not fire upon this aircraft until further orders are transmitted.
How did you manage to damage an SR-71 with a SAM? Those things are infamous for outrunning SAMs. That's how they... I'm sorry, that's one of the ways they bankrupt the freaking Soviet Union during the Cold War. Because these things flew so many freaking sorties. Actually, interesting little bit of history about this thing. The Russians actually, well, the Soviets at the time, but they claimed that they managed to shoot one down when it was actually a public airliner. After all the AA defenses, not a single one of these has ever been shot down. And for some freaking reason, they retired them, probably because of their high cost. That's one thing you gotta know about military, modern militaries. Modern usually means cheap. Do everything they can to downsize the budget. Personally, I think they should downsize welfare programs and unnecessary bureaus, but that's just my opinion. So, let's do this. Supersonic aircraft used by a wide variety of air forces all over the world.
Better be marking our tail, son.
Typically as a cheap alternative.
Looks like you're confident at least. Don't get separated from me.
At the very least, it's friendly on maintenance.
Second Lieutenant Alvin H. Davenport, Sippy.
Versatile enough, it's cheap on maintenance. Fairly inexpensive to own and operate.
That does fit you well. I've got a better name for you, but I'll keep it to myself. Okay? Ah, cut me some slack, man.
You can see it has some of the hallmarks of a later design, like the F-18 Hornet.
You're forbidden to fire until I get permission, understand?
Good boy, one more time. Anyway.
That's your name for me? You got a knack for comic dialogue. You mind sending a surrender request for me? Oh no, please, age before beauty. I'm real shy around strangers, you know. Jeez, testing. Attention, unidentified aircraft. Set your course for our beacon immediately. Good.
Standing. We have four high-speed bogeys.
If you're wondering why it's taking so far away from these guys, is Ace Combat 5 changed something. You can actually crash into your allies now. So you really gotta be wary.
You're not to fire until I'm
speed
bogey zero.
Also has the agility of a school bus.
Heads up! They're firing on us! War Dog Squadron, weapons safe. Hold your fire until further orders. Oh, come on! Those aren't blanks they're firing out there! Shut your mouth and fire back! Captain Bond, this is Thunderhead. You are violating direct orders.
What the?
Shut it. I'm not gonna watch any more of my pilots die.
All right, fine. I can't.
Huh.
All right, since no one's got this guy, I'll take him. Well, if you lost something that expensive, yeah, you'd be pretty pissed too. Whoa! Shut!
Hell, password secret
later. Okay, yep. These guys as possible. Because fuck it, I am not kidding.
Can you hear my voice?
I'm not gonna crash. Or allow one of these idiots to crash
into me. You all alive? Alright. Nice work, Nuggets. War Dog 4, you still follow us? Remembering the fact that we all made it out of that battle alive, I'm gonna let you keep your nickname. From now on, I'm gonna call you Kid, no matter what. Got it?
Okay, this is a good time to introduce you to something. See that little bar there? Where it says F5E? not sure if you can see it. So. Anyway, where it says FIE, F5E, and F4G. Well, basically, you have to complete a certain number of... Basically, you have to get a certain amount of kills and stuff in order to unlock each plane. Now, planes like this, they don't tend to take too long to upgrade. I mean, to progress to the next one, but still. That's how you progress to the next plane. Now, another thing to add to that is that you can only, once you buy a plane, you can't buy any weapons with it. It comes equipped with one sub-weapon, that's it. My personal opinion, this is a step down from the last.
The whole area with the unidentified aircraft was covered up. There was even a rumor going around that it was actually a UFO. Officially, the world was still at peace. Having witnessed the battle myself, I wasn't allowed to leave the island.
Why did he even bother reprimanding me anymore? I know I'm going to be stuck a captain forever.
Who do you think's covering up the battle?
Listen, the only thing across that ocean is Murska Air Base. That's Yuktabanian territory.
But haven't we been allies with the Yuks since the war 15 years ago?
Yeah. That's why we got people working their asses off trying to confirm what the hell's going on over there. I bet they've got hotlines ringing off the hook somewhere upstairs. The government doesn't want to get the public riled up with all this, you know? But it doesn't matter. Soldiers like us are too stupid to think for ourselves, so we just gotta keep our mouths shut when they tell us to. I feel kind of bad for you, actually.
It's all right. I get to be with you guys.
Captain's probably hating this more than anybody.
Hmm?
He used to have a lady friend over in Yuktabanya.
That's just an old war wound now.
Alright. I think that's, I think it's a good time to wrap it up there. Yeah. Jeez. Anyway. So yeah, that was our first flight. An introduction to Ace Combat 5. I want to thank you for watching. Ivan Yeager Bishop. Please like, comment, subscribe, all the good stuff. Click the bell for notifications. And of course, do feel free to leave a donation to my Patreon and PayPal. Links are in Patreon or PayPal. Links in the description below. I will actually start using Patreon to, you know, bring special content, per se. Or should I say, give people special content who donate. Honestly, it doesn't have to be much. It could be, like, a couple bucks a month. It doesn't matter. And, of course, feel free to follow me on my various social media links. All links will be in the description. I thank you for watching. And I'll see you in the skies next time. Take care, everyone.